been getting a lot of questions recently about buy-sell agreements. When we talk about buy-sell agreements, what we mean is an agreement between owners to buy each other out. What we don't mean is an agreement where a business is bought or sold. There are really three reasons why every business needs to have a buy-sell. The first is to avoid being partners with someone who you don't intend to. So this would mean an ex-spouse or the IRS or a bankruptcy trustee. You want to make sure that you're partners with the people you intended to be in the first place. The second reason to have a buy-sell is because just to think of it in a way as a business prenuptial agreement. You want to make sure that you understand how you're going to break up while everyone is still happy at the beginning. And then third, for every business owner, buy-sells are very important as part of the succession plan of the business, and also really part of the individual business owner's estate plan. You want to figure out when somebody passes away, who is going to buy it and for what price. The most difficult issue in dealing with buy-sells is determining how much to pay and what the valuation is. And there's really two different approaches on this. One is to have a formula or to agree to some sort of valuation expert. And then the simpler way, which I actually prefer, is that for every year, business owners determine what the value of the business is and then separate out the ownership accordingly. Financing is another issue. There's really two main ways that buy-sell agreements are financed. The first is through life insurance, particularly on the death of a partner, and the second is to finance the buyout amount over time. All of this needs to be done correctly, and in setting up the buy-sell, you should really talk to your business attorney, your own personal estate planning attorney, and your life insurance professional. I know this is complicated. We can help with that.